Hello. Variables. P5.js, JavaScript. I'm just speaking in single words. Okay, this is a video where I really the topic that I want to look, it's probably going to be a couple videos, is variables. But we've got to ease our way into it. Let's before we even talk about what a variable is, let's think about why. What's missing from the programs that you are writing? In the previous video, I showed you how to draw a static thing to the screen. You could make a rectangle, a circle, color it. And in order to do that, before you could do that, we had to add two things, blocks of code, I'll call them. A block of code is something that begins with an open curly bracket and ends with a closed curly bracket. A setup block and a draw block. Each of these blocks, by the way, is a function. Functions are this fundamental primary element of just about how everything works in JavaScript. So it's going to be a key topic throughout all of the videos that I make. And a function is essentially a way of organizing a block of code, a bunch of lines of instructions all together. There's a bunch of setup instructions and a bunch of draw instructions. I said last week or a couple days ago, whenever I made the last video, that setup is a place where you put create canvas. Create canvas. And create canvas requires two arguments, a width and a height, and you get this nice rectangle on the screen, a canvas for you to draw to. And when it's time to draw to that canvas, you add some instructions in the draw function, like background. Background 0 will give you a black background. And then perhaps you might add something like ellipse. 50, 50, 75, 20, it's a weird looking ellipse, which would then draw, or it would look more like this. Anyway, something like this, right? So this is what we've got so far. There's a setup block and a draw block. Both of those things are functions. There's a bit more to it than just this idea of like, create canvas is in setup and this stuff is in draw. There's a reason why we're putting some things in setup and some things in draw. And it has to do with the flow of a program. I hope I'm recording, I am. A flow of a program over time. If you've ever used any piece of software, you know, there's an element of time there. You launch the software, you do some stuff, some more things happen, you do some more stuff. It doesn't just like start, draw a picture, and end. So a P5 sketch, a browser session, so to speak, it happens over time. And these functions are controlling that flow. How do they control that flow? Setup happens once at the beginning. Setup, when the program runs, the first thing that happens is setup, and it happens once, which makes sense. You don't want to create a canvas more than once. At the beginning, you create the canvas once. Draw, however, does something kind of interesting. It runs through these instructions. After setup finishes, these instructions get executed, and when it gets to the end, it goes right back to the beginning. Background ellipse, to the end, right back to the beginning. Background ellipse, to the end, right back to the beginning. This is known as a loop, and it essentially happens forever. It happens forever until a user closes the window. You know, there's obviously a lot more to this. You could stop and start it, you can have lots of other things happen, but this is our basic beginning flow of the program. Setup happens once, draw loops over and over and over again. I wonder how many times I've talked about setup and draw in my life. Probably like 250. But I enjoy it just as much this time as any other time, by gosh. Okay, let's go over and prove this point here. So here is a P5 sketch, and you can see that it is exactly the same format that I looked at the board. There is a setup function at the top with create canvas, and there are a bunch of drawing things. This is a nice example that Lauren McCarthy prepared unknowingly for me. And if I run it, you can see I love these colors, I love the pink circle, and I love the blue square. Now, it doesn't look like anything's happening over time because it's just like a static picture. It's beautiful, but it doesn't move. And maybe that's okay. Maybe in life all we want to do is make static pictures. But assuming you want to make things move, it's drawing the same thing over and over again, what do we need to do? We need to vary what happens every time draw executes. Draw executes once, twice, third time, fourth time, fifth time. What if something different happened? What if the first time the circle appears up there, then the second time it appears down here, the third time it appears down here, you'll have the illusion of it moving down. Or, even better yet, what if you could just say, every time through draw the circle where the mouse is. So I could do something like ellipse where the mouse is, right? That should be fine. I'm sure that's gonna work. I'm being facetious, I guess, but now we can see that I have an error here. So this is obviously, it's like expected parentheses. This is obviously not correct syntax. P5, JavaScript, they're just not gonna understand your just regular old English language speak thing. However, this is such a common problem that P5 has as a part of its library a variable called mouseX. So I'm gonna put mouseX in here. You can see that it's a nice purple color, right? Because the P5 editor recognized that as a built-in keyword, a variable. And what this means is mouseX is a word that stands for something. 100 is a number that stands for the number 100 and can only ever be the number 100. But mouseX is actually referring to something stored in the computer's memory that changes based on how the user moves the mouse. So if I run this program again, we can see mouseX is 100, maybe it's 200, maybe 300. So now we can see that no matter what I do, draw is happening over and over again, and it's always drawing the ellipse where the mouse is. Wow, this is really... I mean, if you haven't done this before, hopefully this is kind of interesting. Okay, so let's think of, there's a couple more things. There's another thing we could look at here, which is kind of amazing. Now, what happens then if I take some other things and put them in setup? Like this background function. I'm going to put this in setup. Remember, setup happens just once. Draw loops over and over again. I haven't rerun it yet. This is what happened. This is when background was in draw, right? The background is always being filled, and then the ellipse is drawn. The background is filled, then the ellipse is drawn. What happens if the background is drawn only once in setup? You know, think about that for a second. I'm thinking about it. Now I'm going to run this again. Look at this. Every single ellipse from the history of moving, of any time I've moved it, is now visible. This is because we only drew that yellow background once, and everything is drawn sequentially. So this illusion of something moving around the screen only exists if you erase the background each time through draw before you draw the next thing. So this is something you can play with. And in fact, this is a pretty quick path. If I get rid of this rectangle, and I say like no stroke, and I also add mouse Y here, and I run this, now you can see I've made a painting program, which is pretty nice. Like, maybe I give it a little alpha, which is the fourth argument. Maybe I make that a little bit smaller, and I run it again. You can see here's a little program that I can use to kind of paint something with my mouse. So this is actually a great stopping point for this video. I want to look in the next video at how you make your own variables. I have one more thing. I can't. I've been trying to keep my videos at 10 minutes. There's a minute and a half. But there's in this painting program, there's one more thing that I want to show you, which I think is really, really key. Okay? So let's go back to the board over here. And we have setup. That is a function that runs once at the beginning. We have draw. That's a function that happens over and over again. Let's add one more function. And I don't have a lot of room on the whiteboard, so I'm just going to erase draw for a second to put it here. And I'm going to say, what if I have so pretend draw is still there, and it has a background and an ellipse. And I'm going to add another function, and I'm going to call it mouse pressed. So I have now complicated the flow of the program even more, in an interesting way. Setup happens once, and only once at the beginning. Draw loops over and over again. It's just, draws just like a crazy person, like, I'm gonna draw, I'm never gonna stop drawing, I can't stop from drawing. Mouse pressed is a very patient person, quietly sitting aside, just waiting and waiting. In fact, mouse pressed might never, ever happen. program could run, and that code there will never occur. So this is what's known, and this is also a key concept in JavaScript. There's going to be so much more to this. As an event, when the user clicks the mouse, the code here is executed. So draw is just drawing and drawing and drawing and drawing and drawing. The user clicks the mouse. We take a break from draw for a second. We run the code in mouse pressed, and then draw loops and loops. I don't know why I'm saying we. The computer is doing this. The browser is executing all these instructions. So now you have a bit more sophistication here. You have setup, you have draw, and you can always interrupt draw with mouse pressed. So let's go back to our program. I was like, do you have any questions? But there's no way for you to talk to me, and I want you to talk to me somehow, some way. So now over here, what I'm going to do to this program is I'm going to add mouse pressed. And what should we put in mouse pressed? How about we take this background function and we duplicate it in mouse pressed? So you can see when the program first starts, we make the canvas, we draw the background. Then always continuously, we just draw a circle wherever the mouse is, so let the user paint. And then what can the user do? Now, there's a new feature here. The user is moving the mouse, moving the mouse, moving the mouse. And the user might say, who's me? I might say, drawing's not so good. I want to erase it. Clicking the mouse will then execute background, and it's gone. And now I could then, you know, try to draw a D and do something where I sort of draw an A, and I'm like trying to make my name, and I don't know why I'm doing this. So this is pretty interesting. And you've got some tools now. You're missing a lot of things, but with color, with a bit more. What I would say now as an exercise is use setup, use draw, use mouse pressed. You can draw more than just a circle. See what kind of painting program you can make that allows the user interactively to kind of create a drawing on the screen, which is a nice constraint for an assignment. And in the next video, what I will show you is how to create your own variables beyond just what P5 offers for you, like where the mouse is, so you can have something move autonomously on the screen. And I'm gonna make that video right now, by golly, even though it's like after this very long day of like fighting with technology, that is nothing that you need to worry yourself about, is kind of the last thing I want to do. But I'm going to do it. Okay, I have to hit stop.